So how do you start with this now, Charles?
Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the first two examples, and the reason I'm doing that is because I know they both generate true. And so I'm going to look for variables that are inconsistent. So if I look at x1, for example, it's a 1 in the first case and a 0 in the second case, so it can't be the case that it's required in order for this to be true. And the same would be true for x3. So I'm going to say that neither x1 nor x3 matter. By contrast, x2, x4, and x5 all have the same values in both of those cases.
So we don't know much about them quite yet. But let's that seems very well reasoned. So we know that x1 can't be part of this formula, and x3 can't be a part of this formula. So let's sort of imagine that they're not there because they don't really give us any information anymore.
Beautiful.
All right, so what's left?
So what's left is now to make certain that x2, x4, and x5 are necessary, and particularly are necessary with the values that they have. So I guess all I can really do is see if there's anything else to eliminate. If I were just looking at the first two, I would think that the answer was not x2, x4, not x5.
All right, hang on. So not x2, x4, not x5.
Right. So that's what I currently think it is based upon what I just saw.
And that would be that's consistent with the first two examples.
Right. And so now I want to make certain it's consistent with the next three examples. This is the easiest way for me to think about this anyway. So let's see. Not x2, x4. So that should be false, which it is. Well, they're all false. So let's see. Not x2, but x4. Oh, so that should be false, which it is. And then I do the same thing. So wait, why isn't that the answer? That can't be the answer.
It is the answer. You got it.
Huh. I got it right.
So the thing to notice is that in these first two examples, we have x2 is false, x4 is true, and x5 is false. And that's enough to make it make the conjunction true. But flipping any one of those bits is enough to make it false. So what I showed in the remaining examples is that just by turning this x2 and an x1, leaving everything else the same, we lose it. Similarly, if we flip the x4 to a 0 and leave everything else the same, we lose it. Similarly, if we flip x5 to 1 and leave everything else the same, we lose it. So that means that each of these is necessary to make the conjunction. They're all actually in there.
That's just what I was thinking. So in other words, you gave me some positive examples to eliminate things that weren't necessary, and then you gave me negative examples to validate that each of the variables that I saw so far were necessary, because getting rid of any one of them gave me the wrong answer.
Exactly. Let's even write down those two steps. So the first thing was show what's irrelevant, and how many queries might we have needed to show that?
Well, one per variable.
Well, actually, we only need two, because what I did is I used all the relevant ones I kept the same, and all the irrelevant ones I flipped from one to the other. I just have to show you that it's still the output is still one, even though they have two different values.
Oh, no. When I said all of them, k of them, was because I didn't know that. What if all of them were irrelevant?
Then it would still be two, because I can just show you the all zeros and the all ones.
Oh, you're right. You just need, that's right. That's exactly right.
All right, and then I have to show you that that each of the remaining variables is relevant by flipping it and showing you that the answer is zero. And how many questions did I need to do for that?
Three.
Yeah, three in this case, because there were three variables that were used in the formula. What's the most it could be?
Well, k, because all of them could be relevant.
Yeah. So it's kind of interesting that in fact, the total number of hypotheses here is 3 to the k, because you can see it right off this table, that for each of the variables, it's either positive, absent, or negated. But the number of questions that a smart teacher had to ask was more like k plus 2, which is pretty powerful.
Right. So a smart teacher can help me do this in linear time. So what if I were I didn't have the teacher who could give me these examples, and I always had to ask?
That's a good question. Let's do that.